हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सिराजुल हक फैजी। आई वेलकम यू इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सॉलिड स्टेट, सम क्वेश्चंस एंड देयर आंसर्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। Why are solid rigid? So answer of this question is, the intermolecular forces of attractions that are present in solid are very strong. The constituent particles of solid cannot move from their positions. That is, they have fixed positions. However, they can oscillate about their mean positions. This is the reason solid are rigid. Now friend, the second question is, why do solid have a definite volume? The answer of this question is, the intermolecular forces of attraction that are present in solid are very strong. The constituent particle of solid have fixed positions, and that is, they are rigid, and solid have a definite volume. Now friends, our next questions, classify the following as amorphous or crystalline solid: polyurethane, naphthalene, benzoic acid, teflon, potassium nitrate, cellophane, polyvinyl chloride, fiberglass, and copper. So answer of this question is, amorphous solid, polyurethane, teflon, cellophane, polyvinyl chloride, fiberglass, and crystalline solid, naphthalene, benzoic acid, potassium nitrate, and copper. Now our next questions: why is glass considered a supercooled liquid? The answer of this question is, similar to liquids, glass has a tendency to flow, though very slowly. Therefore, glass is considered as a supercooled liquid. This is the reason that glass windows and doors are slightly thicker at the bottom than at the top. Now, next question is, refractive index of a solid is observed to have the same value along all directions. Comment on the nature of this solid. Would it show cleavage property? Answer of this question is, an isotropic solid has the same value of physical properties when measured along different directions. Therefore, the given solid having the same value of refractive index along all directions is isotropic in nature. Hence, the solid is an amorphous solid. When an amorphous solid is cut with the sharp edges tool, it cut into two pieces with irregular surface. Now friends, question number 6. Classify the following solid in different categories based on the nature of intermolecular forces operating in them: potassium sulfate, tin, benzene, urea, ammonia, water, zinc sulfide, graphite, rubidium, argon, silicon, carbide. The answer is potassium sulfate, ionic solid; tin, metallic solid; benzene, molecular solid; urea, polar molecular solid; ammonia, polar molecular solid; water, hydrogen bonded molecular solid; zinc sulfide, ionic solid; graphite, covalent or network solid; rubidium, metallic solid; argon, nonpolar molecular solid; silicon carbide, covalent or network solid. Now our next question is, solid A is very hard electrical insulator in solid as well as in molten state, and melts at extremely high temperature. What type of solid is it? So how you will like the answer of this question? The given properties are the properties of a covalent or network solid. Therefore, the given solid is a covalent or network solid. Example of such solid include diamond and quartz. Now, the next question is, ionic solid conduct electricity in molten state but not in solid state. Explain it. Very important questions. In ionic compound, electricity is conducted by ions. In solid state, ions are held together by strong electrostatic forces and are not free to move about within the solid. Hence, the ionic solid do not conduct electricity in solid state. However, in molten state or in solution form, the ions are free to move and can conduct electricity. Now friends, the next question is, what type of solid are electrical conductor, malleable and ductile? The answer is, metallic solid are electrical conductor, malleable and ductile. Now friends, our last question of this video, give the significance of a lattice point. The significance of lattice point is that each lattice point represents one constituent particles of a solid, which may be an atom, a molecule. A molecule means a group of atom or an atom. So friend, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.